three or four weeks ago, I think it was Sherry, asked me to repeat new minor forcing. And I don't mind reviewing anything. I seldom learn something the first time through. I like to go back and review things on a regular basis because invariably I note a point that slipped through the cracks the first time that I looked at it. And so I'm often surprised by how much I learned by going back and reviewing something I thought I already knew. The rest of you may already know new minor forcing, but bear with us. We've got a new subject for next week. Now, when everybody starts learning to play bridge, they learn pretty quickly that an eight card fit in a major suit, particularly the 4-4 fit, is the holy grail in this game. It's what everybody is looking for. Right behind it is the 5-3 fit. I've played many 6-2 fits. Oh, and I don't believe I've ever played a 7-1. I may have once or twice. But the eight card major suit fit is what we all search for. That's our first choice of a place to play. And only if we find that we cannot play an eight card major suit fit will we look for that no trump game. So, new minor forcing deals with the situation that happens when opener bids one of a minor, responder bids one of a major, and the opener rebids one no trump, denying four card support for the responder's major. And if responder's major was hearts, it also denies one spade. So, denies having four spades, rather, I should say. So, on an auction that goes one minor, one heart, one no trump, it strongly suggests that the opener has length in the minors and shortness in the majors. He does not have a four card major suit when that happens, when that major that's bid is hearts. Because if he had four spades, it's not impossible that responder has four hearts and four spades. He bids them up the line so that the opener can show four spades and they can find that 4-4 spade fit if it exists. So, what happens though if responder has five cards in his major suit? What happens? Well, let's as I just said, bidding four card majors up the line finds four major suit fits. One club, one heart, two hearts, four hearts. Pretty straightforward. They have found the 4-4 major suit fit. This other example shows a 4-4 fit in spades. They find the 4-4 fit when opener did not bid a major suit. Those of you who have been around as long as I have may have originally learned Gorin. When you play Gorin with these two hands, this first hand, this hand on the left here, would open one heart. This hand would open one heart. This hand would rebid one spade, two spades. We don't bid that way anymore. We use a five card major system. The thing with Gorin is you opened 14 point hands, not 11 and 12 point hands. When you don't have as many points, you need to have a better suit. I mean, that just kind of stands to reason, doesn't it? You can see how that would work. The result is that a lot of people had to learn how to play 4-3 fits. 4-3 fits were not considered terrible. 4-4s were better, but you played a lot of 4-3 fits. Well, that's kind of dependent on having your trumps split well for you to work out well. Now, if the opener has a six card major suit, he can rebid it at the appropriate level. If he has a minimum opening hand, he'll rebid two of his major suit. If he has an invitational level hand, he'll bid three of his major suit. So, for instance, in this first slide on the left here, one heart, one spade, two hearts, one club. If you assume the hand on the left is the opener, one club, one heart, one no trump, implying two card heart support And no four card spade suit. And as you can see, that is correct. Now, with this very distributional hand, and knowing that his partner should have at least two hearts in his hand for his one no trump bid, if he doesn't have two hearts, then he has a lot of shape, and odds are really good that he would bid a second suit rather than one no trump. This hand on the left looks pretty no trumpy though, doesn't it? Well, the hand on the right is not no trumpy at all. So he just bids four hearts. He has 14 points in a void and has good reason to believe that his partner has two hearts. And so this is the way that people find 6-2 fits when the responder holds a six card major suit. Well, you've heard me say many, many times, folks, it's easy to find a 5-3 fit when it's the opener who holds the five card major suit. Because we play a five card major system, opening one of the major promises five, and so responder can raise with only three cards in his hand. So, in this first slide, once the responder bids two hearts, opener should have no problem bidding the game with that very nice hand he has. And conversely, if they both just have a minimum hand for their bids, then they still find the five card fit in spades. And it works out pretty well, I think. So, what happens though when it's the responder who has a five card major and the opener has three cards in the suit? How do we find it? A lot of people will say, well, I like to rebid my five card suit. Well, what would be wrong with that? Does anybody have any idea about why bidding one club, one heart, one no trump here, two hearts? Why is that not a good bidding sequence? Does anybody know?
Chose a six card suit.
Yeah. When you rebid a major suit, in fact, when you rebid a major or a minor, about 95% of the time, you're going to have a six card suit. Rebidding a suit implies six of them. And I mean, notice this hand has 5, 7, 10, 11 high card points in it. When you rebid two hearts, you're saying, I have 6 to 9 points and a six card suit, partner. Fold them up. We're going to play it here, unless you have a great big old hand. So, two hearts does not adequately describe the strength of the hand either, does it? So, bidding one heart and rebidding two hearts isn't the right answer, doesn't give the opener the right information about your hand. So we tell openers not to raise with only three card support. Now, there are a couple of instances where raising with three card support is preferable to any of your other choices, but those don't come up very often. And so we're going to focus on the times when you shouldn't do it. For instance, if you hold this hand and you hear your partner bid a heart, he only promises 6 points and he only promises four hearts. The lack of a roughing value in this hand right here would persuade me to rebid one no trump rather than two hearts every time. My partner cannot use any of my small trumps to rough out losers because I have no shortness in my hand anywhere. And if he only has four hearts, he needs some shortness in my hand to have a play for the contract at all. So in this instance, the opener rebids one no trump. But what happens now when it's the responder's turn to bid again? When the responder has, as in this hand, let me see, 10, 12, 13 high card points. I thought I'm, well, 14 counting the fifth heart here. This is a hand worth 14 points. Partner opened. We need to get to game. How can I bid in such a way that my partner knows that I have five hearts? I want to play the heart game if we can. It's not clear out of reason that when my partner rebid one no trump, that he would have three hearts in his hand. So what can I do? Well, here are his options. He can rebid two hearts. We've already talked about why that is not the appropriate bid. Once responder bids and rebids his suit, that denotes a very weak hand and opener should pass. That is the responder's way of signing off, saying, if we're going to play this hand, we need to play it here. You know, oftentimes when opener has a really strong hand and he picks it up, he can hardly wait. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, this is a big hand. I'm going to get to play a big contract. How much fun will that be? And then your partner bids and rebids a suit, showing a weak hand and a long suit. When one hand is strong and the other one is weak with a long suit, it is often better to let the weak hand with the long suit play the contract. So that's why you don't want to rebid two hearts with a hand like this. Number one, it would promise six, and number two, it would say, I have a weak hand. You need to make a forcing bid. Remember, responder has to find out information in order to place the contract appropriately. He needs to have forcing bids so that he can get answers to the questions he has. Now, once your partner has rebid one no trump and limited his hand, your options for making a forcing bid are very limited. After opener has limited his hand by rebidding one no trump, saying, I have a 12 to 14 point hand here, partner, and I don't have four hearts with you. Well, we could bid two hearts, but we've already said that's wrong for several reasons. How about two no trump? Is two no trump forcing here?
No, it's not.
Absolutely not. Two no trump is forward going, but never forcing. Your partner should look at that two no trump call and say, well, he has enough to invite me to game and I should bid game if I'm on 14 or if I have 13 and a good excuse, like a five card minor suit or something. Or partner has 11 or 12 points. I have 12. I don't think that we're going to make three no trump. So two no trump is not forcing here. How about three hearts? Three hearts is an option. What would be wrong with rebidding three hearts here?
That would indicate a stronger hand, I think.
Well, you have an opening hand.
Up that concrete.
That indicates six hearts.
Yes, it does. It promises six hearts. I don't have six hearts. I could bid three no trump. But if my partner has the right distribution, we might make four or five hearts and we'd be better off. There's a reason why we want to play in that eight card major suit fit first. Three no trump is the option when we don't have an eight card fit. I don't know yet whether we have an eight card fit. I need a way to be able to find out whether my partner has three card heart support. What can I do? And of course, four hearts is a possibility, but you don't know how many hearts your partner has. He may have only two, and then you do belong in three no trump. In other words, responder is the decider, and he does not have enough information yet to make the decision. So what to do, what to do? Well, three no trump and four hearts are both reasonable here. But you may end up finding out that your partner only has two hearts and you belonged in three no trump if you bid four hearts. Or you may bid three no trump and find out your partner had queen third, like in that example before, and you did belong in four hearts because you can make four hearts, but only three no trump because nobody has a great long suit to run. So what are we going to do? Well, when he has a minimum hand, he has to make a non-forcing bid. Just as in the example we talked about previously, opener bids a diamond, responder bids a heart, one no trump, two hearts. That says, partner, I'd have opened a weak two if you hadn't opened in front of me. That's basically what that bidding describes. A weak two bid in hearts in responder's hand. The opener is expected to put down the green card. In this instance, if you use only natural bids, one club, one heart, one no trump, two clubs, taking a preference. This shows four or five hearts and at least five clubs. Why does it show five clubs? Because partner opened a convenient minor. He could have only three of them. You don't raise a convenient minor with three-card support the same way you do when it's a major that your partner opened. This implies an unbalanced hand when you do that. If you have a balanced hand, opener has said he has a balanced hand. If you also have a balanced hand, you just pass. So this strongly implies an unbalanced hand and says, I think it'd be better if we played two clubs than one no trump. Now then, one diamond by the opener, one spade by responder, one no trump by opener, and now two hearts. This two-heart bid is a new suit by the responder, but it is not forcing because opener limited his hand with that one no trump rebid. He has limited his hand by rebidding one no trump. That means that unless you have a special agreement with your partner, that a new suit by the responder is no longer forcing. This particular bidding pattern shows a minimum responding hand with five spades and either four or five hearts. We don't know for sure, but responder bids this way in case opener has four hearts. He had to bid one spade first because he had five of them. Remember, we bid four card suits up the line when we're responding, but when we have five in spades and four or five hearts, we bid the spades first. Now responder bids two hearts saying, hey partner, well, okay, I know you don't have four spades. Do you happen to have four hearts? I'm 5-4 or maybe even 5-5 in the major suits. Surely we can play in one of these. Or when there is a jump shift in the other minor. Note, a jump shift. And now this is not the way that everyone agrees to play this particular hand pattern, but it is certainly a viable way to play it. When your partner opens a diamond, you have six cards in the other minor, and you have a four-card major suit. Particularly if you only have 6 to 9 points or 6 to 10 total points, not high card points, total points, then you really can't bid at the two level, particularly if you play two of one. So what the responder has to do in that instance is bid that four card major. Remember, we talked about when you have a longer minor and a four-card major and you have just something less than an opening hand, you get that four-card major on the table first. Opener rebids one no trump, saying, don't have four hearts, also don't have four spades. Three clubs now says, I have four hearts and six clubs, partner. What do you think? And I only promise a minimum responding hand. Remember, jump shifts by responder have gone the way of the dinosaurs. So this does not show a strong hand. So what if responder doesn't have a minimum responding hand? What if he has that 11 to 12 or a good 10 to 12 points? Well, he has a few more options available to him. When he has a game invitational hand, he can raise partners one no trump to two no trump, which is not forcing, as we've discussed. He can use a jump rebid in his major suits, but as we've said before, that promises a six-card suit. Now, here is one instance where the jump shift can be used, but it doesn't formally. A jump shift by responder showed at least an opening hand, typically more than 14 high card points. The way it's played these days, a jump shift in the major suits promises 5 cards in each major and a hand that can invite to game. Here's an example of that first one. 1 diamond, 1 heart, 1 no trump, 2 no trump. I have, you know, I may have 4 or 5 hearts. These are all natural bids. These are the natural bid options. 1 diamond, 1 spade, 1 no trump, 3 spades. I have an invitational hand with 6 spades. What do you think, partner? This bid should be absolutely forcing. Yes, it is a rebid of the same suit, but we've gone beyond 2 no trump. Opener should either bid 4 spades or 3 no trump, depending on what his hand looks like to him. 1 diamond, 1 spade, 1 no trump, 3 hearts. Notice that this looks almost like the hand that has 6 to 10 points in it with at least 5-4 in the major suits. The difference is here, jumping to 3 hearts promises 5 cards in the heart suit. At least 5 cards in spades, maybe 6, with at least 5 cards in the heart suit. Notice he jumps to 3 hearts rather than rebidding 2 hearts. This asks partner to take his choice between the 2 major suits. Now then, there's one special bid out there that is sort of strange looking. We used to call it the impossible 2-spade bid. When the responder has an opening hand and has no other way in his arsenal to force his partner to bid again, he can use 2 spades in this particular auction to force the opener to bid again. 1 diamond, 1 heart, 1 no trump, 2 spades. Why can responder absolutely not want to play spades? This can't be a bid saying, I want to play spades. Why can't it?
Well, he's already denied 4 spades when he bid a no trump.
Yes.
So,
right, exactly. Responder knows that opener does not have 4 spades in his hand. So why in the world would he bid 2 spades? Well, there can be only one answer. He wants to force the bidding. He has a game-going hand. And so he makes a game-forcing reverse. This is a reverse. He bid the lower-ranking suit first. Basically, this bid is used to ask the opener, do you have 3 cards in my heart suit? I have a 5-card heart suit. Do you have 3? This is the way that you can do that if you don't play new minor forcing. Notice how all these options that we have here for both invitational and game forcing hands, where we have to dance around a lot, maybe. And when we have to decide whether we're going to play hearts or no trump. Now, when you use the impossible 2-spade bid, it absolutely shows a game-forcing hand because it's a reverse. When you use new minor forcing, you don't have to have a game-forcing hand. You can have an invitational hand only. You cannot use it, though, with a minimum responding hand because if partner doesn't have 3 cards with you in your 5-card major, you're going to end up playing 2 no trump. You need about 23 points between the 2 hands to be successful in 2 no trump. So, if responder has only 7 or 8 points and the opener has 12, you don't have a snowball's chance in 2 no trump, do you? So that's the reason that you have to have an invitational level hand to use new minor forcing. I've gone through a whole lot of preliminaries here to get you to the point that I hope you can see, and that is what a valuable convention new minor forcing is. You don't have to remember a whole bunch of bids that describe this situation and that situation. You have a way to ask your partner, hey, do you have three card heart support for me or three card spade support for me? Or do you have four cards in the other major suit? It's entirely possible that responder has both majors. So this is some examples of the opening of one of a minor or one of a major and how the opener can end up rebidding one no trump. We can end up there a whole bunch of different ways, right? And this assumes that the opponents are passing. Opponents are not always so accommodating, but for the sake of discussion, we're going to say that they are here. In any of these instances, the bid of the other minor, that is the one that opener did not bid, is called new minor forcing. We've talked about before how responders' rebids over a one no trump rebid by opener are not forcing because opener limited his hand. Well, when you decide to play new minor forcing, the new minor is forcing. It absolutely is forcing. So in the auction, one club, one heart, one no trump, two diamonds says, I have five cards in my major suit. Do you have either three cards there with me, or do you have four cards in the other major? This is not a real diamond suit, and you know what that means. When it is not a natural bid, it must be alerted. Deborah, do you have a question?
I do. I always am concerned when I rebid as opener one no trump, and I don't have one of the suits covered. Is that something I should be concerned about?
When the opponents don't give you a reason to worry about a suit, don't worry about it.
Okay.
How do they give you a reason to worry? They bid the suit, right? And so they have to find that suit. If you don't have a stop, maybe your partner does. I mean, after all, he has at least an invitational hand over here to use new minor forcing. Now, when the opponents are bidding and the opener rebids one no trump, it strongly implies that he has a stop. But a one no trump response, say one diamond, one no trump by the responder, doesn't promise anything, really, because all it says is, I don't have enough to bid at the two level. I don't have a four card major suit. I don't have enough cards in your minor suit to raise you to two. It's the I don't have catch all bid. I have values. I have nothing else to bid. So you would like for it to promise a stop if the person sitting to your right bid, but it does not promise it automatically. All it says to your partner is, I have some values. I have no other call I can make. You see the difference?
Yes.
All righty. So in all of these instances here, when the opponents are passing, the bid of the other minor is a one-round force, and it specifically asks the opener to describe his major suit holdings. What do you give up when you do this? You give up the ability to bid this other minor suit naturally. Say you have that weak hand that has four hearts and six clubs in it. For instance, on this auction right here, two clubs is new minor forcing. If responder has four hearts and six clubs, now he has to jump to three clubs to show four hearts and six clubs. You give up the ability to use two clubs in its natural way. But I promise that's not enough to worry about. Roy, do you have a question?
Yes. You said this was an uncontested bidding.
Yes. In general,
so if they bid anything, new minor forcing, you don't engage that.
And this would be a bid by the person sitting in the fourth seat, because it's already gone. And once new minor forcing is used on the second round of bidding, not the first. But if the opponents jump in there, most people have the agreement that new minor forcing is on over a double, off with a bid. And remember, for those of you, I believe we've talked about support doubles. If that person sitting in the fourth chair sticks a bid in, opener shows three-card support by pulling out the double card. You still have a way to show three-card support. So it's not like you're completely
lost.
Okay?
Got it. Thank you.
So, and this should be alerted as my partner is asking me about my major suit holdings. All right. Now, how does the opener reply? If you look online and you read articles, and there are loads of them, there are two ways of prioritizing openers' rebids. Some pairs want the opener to show three-card support for responders' major suit first. That's the first in the order of priorities. Other people say, no, that's a 5-3 fit. If the opener has four cards in the other major, he should show that first. In the event that responder has five cards in one major and four in the other, that enables you to find the superior 4-4 fit. And other people use it also. Of course, the level of the response is going to show whether the opener is at the top or the bottom of that 12 to 14 point range that he showed. So if you agree that showing three card support is the most important thing, you would do that first. Your second option would be to show four cards in the other major, the unbid major, and also at the same time, opener shows responder how strong his hand is. So, here we go.
I have a question, Susan.
Yes, ma'am.
If he had the other four card major, wouldn't he have bid it instead of one no trump?
Well, in the case that it's one heart, if he had four spades, he would have bid it then. This mostly pertains to when responder has spades. All righty. If we're looking at this, we have, when one diamond was the opening bid, we have a bunch of responses that we can use. Two diamonds over two clubs denies three spades or four hearts and says, I'm a minimum hand. In other words, my strength and length are in the minor suits. Two hearts, for instance, one diamond, one spade, one no trump, two clubs, two hearts, if you have said that this is the way you want to prioritize your responses, denies three spades but shows four hearts, and it can be either maximum or minimum. Two spades would show spade support and a minimum hand. Two no trump denies either four cards in the unbid major or three cards in responder's major, and it should show a maximum 14 points. Many people do not differentiate by using the first bid minor suit. This two diamond call, they just bid two no trump here, denying major suits that responder asked opener to show. So you don't find this two diamond bid used very much anymore. Three diamonds, in other words, jumping to three diamonds, shows a dead minimum of five diamonds, but in most cases should be six or could be six. And it denies, of course, either support for the spade suit or four cards in the unbid major. And, of course, it shows a maximum because we've jumped. This shows a maximum here. Now, remember, minimum and maximum have to be interpreted according to the context of this bidding. Because the opener rebid one no trump, he has 12 to 14 points. If he had 15 and a balanced hand, he would not have opened one diamond or one club. He'd have opened one no trump, right? To save having a rebid problem. So we know that he has at most 14 high card points. And then finally, three spades says, I do have three card support for you, and I have a maximum hand for my bidding. I have a maximum. If he had a minimum, say he had a reasonable 11 count and opened, then he would rebid only two spades. Noting here that just a minimum bid says I have the minimum for my one no trump response, but I do have three spades with you. If you don't have a game going hand, two spades could very well be high enough. Now, after he has opened one diamond here, now this is after a club opener. I think I've got a typo here. This is a club opener. We don't have that two diamond bid available that I talked about on the previous slide, because that's the new minor. So we don't have that available to us. So one club, one heart, one no trump, two diamonds, alert. Two hearts would show three card support and a minimum opening hand. Two spades is that impossible two spade bid that we talked about. Because he rebid one no trump, responder knows he can that opener does not have four spades. But he's interested because notice he has five hearts and four spades. And when we have a five card major, we bid it first. Two no trump denies three card heart support. Three diamonds denies support for either, in this case, it would be three clubs. I'm sorry, I've got typos here. After a one club opener, three clubs then denies spade support. It is a maximum and it shows a long club suit. Three hearts rather than just two hearts shows three card heart support and a maximum in the context of this bidding. Now then, when you have 5-4 in the major suits, you can still use new minor forcing. One diamond by opener, one spade. Remember, when we have five cards in one of the major suits, we bid it first. So one spade comes first here. One no trump. 12 to 14 points, balanced hand, may have four hearts. Why can't the opener rebid two hearts? That would be a reverse. This one no trump bid says he has a minimum opening hand, and to reverse into two hearts here promises at least 17 high card points, longer diamonds than hearts, and is absolutely forcing for one round. So opener doesn't have enough to bid the reverse, so he has to bid one no trump. And of course, if you're a responder holding this hand, you're not very interested in no trump, are you? You've got 5-4 in the majors and a void in clubs, but you can still bid two clubs, even though you don't have a club in your hand, because this is not a natural bid. And it's in red because your partner has to say alert. Now, when opener rebids two hearts, he did have four hearts, but he didn't have the money to buy the two level. That's exactly what responder needed to know. He bids the game in hearts. So even when we don't find a fit in the first major, we can often find it in the second just by using new minor forcing. Now, when responder follows up, if the opener, your partner, has shown a maximum hand, then you're in a game force. because he's got 14 points and you have a hand that's at least invitational. That establishes a game force. If opener shows a minimum when he rebids at the two level, any bid at the two level there can be passed. And at this point, after two rounds of bidding, the responder should know about the hand to place the contract accurately. If you want to use new minor forcing, then you and your partner have to discuss how you're going to bid when you have slam interest. That can be accomplished by, once the trump suit is set, if the person who's interested in slam has a worthless doubleton, or like in the previous case, a void in his hand, bids at the four level are control showing. But if there are no worthless doubletons or voids, then you may elect to use key card. Now then, the bidding goes one club, one spade, one no trump, and it's your call as the responder. This is your hand as responder. Now then, you have enough to use new minor forcing. You have 11 high card points and a doubleton. That's certainly enough. So, partner may have three spades. Using new minor forcing, you'll bid two diamonds. If he bids two hearts, you can bid two no trump. That says to partner, sorry, miss, I had five spades, but I don't have four hearts. Partner will pass two no trump if he has a minimum. He will bid three no trump if he has 14. So notice 11 high card points opposite the maximum can still produce game and no trump. Or he can pass two no trump if he has a minimum. Now then, here's another one. One club, one spade, one no trump. Now it's your call. Once partner bids one no trump, he denies having four spades. You don't have four hearts. You have 12 points in your hand, though. So, absolutely, in this case, you would bid two no trump to invite game in no trump. Once you start playing new minor forcing, opener now knows that you do not have five spades. When you don't use new minor forcing, opener will know that you do not have five spades. Here's another hand. One club, one spade, one no trump. Now it's your turn. This is a game forcing hand, isn't it? This is a very nice hand, in fact. So, using new minor forcing will let you explore for the possibility of either a 5-3 spade fit or a 4-4 heart fit. If partner responds in spades, showing that he has three card support, you'll bid game in spades. If partner bids two hearts, saying, depending on what your agreement is, which one he shows, if he bids two hearts, my partners and I have said that we will show four cards in the other major. I'm a nut for finding 4-4 fits over 5-3s. So my agreement with most of my partners is showing four cards in the other major first. So if partner bids two hearts, you can bid the heart game and play your 4-4 fit and use your nice five-card spade suit for possible discards. If partner rebids two no-trump or three clubs, now you can just bid three no-trump. So even when you have 5-4 in the majors, you can still find an eight-card major suit fit or play in no-trump, whichever is appropriate. Now, one club, one spade, that's a terrible, terrible spade suit, isn't it? But there are five of them. You know, many's the time I've opened one heart with a 9-high suit or one spade with a 10-high suit. I don't like it, but I do it. I'm not going to cover up five cards in a major suit just because they're lousy. All I promise is five. I don't promise the ace, king, queen, jack. So after one no trump, what are you going to do? You have four hearts. But because you have only 9 points and partner has told you he's a minimum opener, there is no game available on this hand. You do not have the required invitational level points. So in this case, even though you may have a 5-3 spade fit or a 4-4 heart fit, you have to pass. Standard American bidding has some limitations. It's not surprising that many of them have to do with responders' hands that are weak. There are enough values to respond, but opposite a minimum opening, you don't have enough room to find out whether you have a major suit fit. If you bid two spades here now with only five of them, and partner has only two small, queen or queen doubleton, something like that, opposite that, you're going to lose too many trump tricks to get a good score. You just, when you're sitting here looking at a hand like this and a suit like those spades are, now move the diamond king and the club queen over to the spades, and I'm rebidding two spades, and partner should pass, because by then I'll have six or seven spades and I'll still have my same 9 points here. So it all depends on where the honors are as to what you can do. If you had another spade, you could rebid two spades. But again, that is still bid in the hope that partner has some stuff in spades. He may or he may not. That's, you pays your money and you takes your choice, right? So, one club, one spade, one no trump, two diamonds. With this hand, I think you know by now, you have a minimum opening hand, and you have three card spade support, so two spades. Partner would not have bid new minor forcing if she only had a four card major suit. So you know she has five. You have a minimum hand with three card support, so two spades is the call. If partner has a game forcing hand, he'll bid the game. Now then, what's the difference between these two hands? Can anybody tell me? This one and the one on the previous slide? What do you think? That previous hand was minimum, wasn't it? Is this a minimum opening hand?
Game forcing.
Absolutely. This hand is maximum for that one no trump rebid. Not only do you have three card spade support, you have two very fine spades, and you have a good hand besides. This is a hand that doesn't bid two spades, it bids three spades. If you just bid two spades with this hand and your partner just has an invitational level hand, he is liable, unless he has really good distribution, to pass two spades. You don't want him to pass two spades. But you don't know exactly how strong his cards are. So when you have a maximum opener, bid three spades when you have three card support. Because that lets partner know that even if he has only invitational values, you belong in game. Why doesn't he just bid four spades? Well, we don't know yet exactly how strong responder's hand is. Maybe he wants to Q-bid because he has slam interest. Remember, when you have a good hand, go slowly. By bidding three spades, you have conveyed that you have a maximum for your bid. If partner has anything beyond game interest, you have now left him room to Q-bid, or if he has everything, if he has the appropriate hand, he can use key card.
Susan?
Yes.
I thought with that, to bid the other minor two diamond bid, that you as responder have to have about 11 points, high card points.
You do.
So Okay.
Yeah. So in other words, my point is on that previous hand is let your partner know when you have a maximum so that if he has only 11, he'll know that game is in the offing. Once partner jumps to three of the major, that should be a game force because he has a maximum and responder has at least an invitational level hand. At least is the key phrase. He may have quite a lot more. And if he does, by bidding just three spades, you allow him to show control or to, obviously, you don't have to stop at three for him to bid four, no trump, if he wants to. But many times, you may have a worthless doubleton in your hand, and you would like to find out whether partner has something for you in that suit, either first or second round control. So the way that you do that, you have to think about what your partner might want to show you. When you bid, you need to choose the bid that gives your partner the greatest number of options. He doesn't have just an invitational hand guaranteed. He has at least that, but he may have a game force himself, or he may have slam interest. So you need to think about those things before you bid. What might partner have? How can I convey the nature of my hand without taking up a whole gob of bidding space? A lot of the reasons that people jump to game is because there are still a number of people out there who do not understand forcing bids. This three spade bid here on that previous slide is an absolute game force. So part of the key to good bidding is to be aware of what's forcing and how the responder especially needs to be familiar with what bids are forcing. That is one of the major keys to good bidding in the standard American system. So here is an example of what I was talking about previously and why you need to talk with your partner before you decide what your first response is when you hold a hand like this. You have three card support for partner's bid suit, but you also have four cards in the other major. Which one should I bid first? Some players feel that the priority should be showing support in partner suit. And that there are certainly merits to that position. But then there are others of us who are so in love with playing 4-4 major suits over 5-3 fits that if I'm holding this hand, I'm going to rebid two hearts just in case partner has five spades and four hearts. A 4-4 fit is generally slightly better than the 5-3. Now, that doesn't mean that in one suit, the trumps may split better than in the other. We're not going to worry about things we can't control. Over the long haul, a 4-4 fit is superior to the 5-3. Because you can use that five-card suit to pitch losers once you have pulled the trumps. So I would bid two hearts here with this hand, but that's not written in stone. You and your partners should decide how you're going to bid when this happens. And if you play long enough, this will come up often enough to make bidding four hearts definitely worth it. But just make sure that you and your partner have discussed it. If you haven't discussed it, if you have a new partner, you should probably just show support at the appropriate level. In this case, you would bid two spades. Now, what if I really have diamonds here and I'm bidding it? My partner thinks that I have five in the major. Well, you're going to have five in the major when you bid two diamonds here. In this auction as shown. If partner rebids two no trump, now you can bid three diamonds. That shows five hearts and five diamonds and is absolutely forcing. Or if you prefer, one club, one heart, one no trump, three diamonds. You might pick one of these as being the invitational sequence and one is the forcing sequence. This one, I think, should be forcing right here. Absolutely. But you pay your money and you take your choice. Now then. All right. one club, pass one spade, pass two no trump. What kind of hand does opener have here?
Big one.
Yeah, 18 or 19 points, right? Exactly, 18 or 19 high card points. Now, most of the time it's 18. So if I can use new minor forcing over one no trump, can I use it over two no trump? Absolutely. What are the point requirements now? Do I still need 11 points? No.
Oh.
No. What would be invitational in this sequence? Invitational would be, let's see, if we got 18, invitational might be 6 or 7, right?
Right.
Yeah. So 7 high card points, but you still need to have a 5 card major, obviously. So now, if responder bids at the 3 level over 2 no trump, it is now a game forcing auction. The only way to stop the bidding following that 2 no trump rebid is to put down the green card. If you bid over 2 no trump, it's game forcing. You can still use new minor forcing. You promise only about 7-ish points when you do that. So if you don't have, if you have 6 points or if you have 5 high card points in a doubleton, you need to pass 2 no trump, even if you do have 5 spades here. My only point is that you do not need as many points to use new minor forcing in this scenario as you do when partner rebids 1 no trump. Now, what if opener starts with 1 heart instead of 1 of a minor? 1 heart, 1 spade. Opener didn't start with a minor suit. Can we still use new minor forcing? That doesn't make sense. There's no new minor. They're both new minors, aren't they? Well, by general consensus, you and your partner can have a different agreement if you want to. But by and large, 2 clubs is new minor forcing in that scenario. Now, remember, you have to have 5 spades, and you shouldn't have at least 3 hearts in that instance. If you have 3 hearts, you're going to end up in hearts, no doubt. So anytime you have a choice of which way to bid, choose the one that saves bidding space. Bidding space is very, very valuable when you have good hands. Remember, when you have good hands, you go slowly. It's when you have few points and long suits that you jump and take up a lot of bidding space. Bidding space is so valuable that you want to choose the bid that will save the most bidding space. Roy, do you have another question?
Well, what you're saying here is if you do not play 2 over 1, you can use new minor forcing to promote the bidding.
Well, you could.
But if you use 2 over 1, 2 clubs has a different meaning, right?
No. Because it went 1 minor, 1 major, 1 no trump. That is not a 2 over 1 auction.
Oh, okay. Well, I missed the first part of that.
Yeah. When you use new minor forcing, generally opener has been a minor, responder has been a major, and he has 5 of them. In the standard American bidding system, there is no convenient way to show exactly 5 cards in responder's major without doing something else, because rebidding it shows 6. Deborah?
The opener starts with 1 heart.
Uh-huh.
The 2 clubs is by responder?
No. 1 heart, 1 spade by responder. 2 clubs would be 1 heart, 1 spade, 1 no trump, 2 clubs would be the way the auction would go. 1 heart by opener, 1 spade by responder, 1 no trump by opener, 2 clubs. Now is new minor forcing.
Okay, so it's the normal progression.
Yes.
1 heart.
Yes, obviously, if the opener bids 1 spade, then if you have 5 hearts, you just, and You have at least 10 points if you don't play two over one. If you have an opening hand, you can bid two hearts directly with five of them. So okay. This is only in the instance when opener starts with a heart, responder bids a spade, opener rebids one no trump. When responder has at least an invitational hand and five spades in his hand, two clubs, by definition, is new minor forcing.
Gotcha.
Okay. Well, I've gone over a little bit today, guys. This last slide is just some links for you to use if you want more information on new minor forcing. This is just a starting point. You know, you need to take some of these points and discuss them with your partners. This is an extremely useful bid. If you don't use it, you have to be very proficient in using that impossible two-spade bid. You give up very little. You give up the ability to rebid that new minor, showing that you have five cards in that suit. But the problem with that is you seldom want to play in that suit. If you can't find a fit in a major suit, you usually want to play no trump. So giving that up is really not a lot to sacrifice to be able to use new minor forcing. So think about it, try it. You'll miss it a few times. I mean, that's a given, guys. It happens. It's the way you learn. We learn through making mistakes. So be patient with yourselves and email me your questions.
Hi, this is Susan. Thanks for stopping by the Oklahoma Collective's YouTube channel. Basically, this channel shows recordings of our free one-hour bridge lessons for advancing players that we offer every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. Central Time. If you would like to join us, send your contact information to the email address shown on the screen, and we'll be happy to send you the link. If you would like to follow our channel and be notified when a new recording is uploaded, just click the Oklahoma Collective button below. Thanks for stopping by. Bye.